Okay, so today what are the topics we are going to discuss is, so today we are going to take, we derived the global stiffness matrix, we know, got to know. Now next step is, what are the boundary condition methods are there? Then after that, procedure for solve the 1D bar element, that is we are going to take up procedure. After that, we are going to begin with the numerical part. That is important. So here, first we are taking what are the types of boundary condition we are going to apply. So here there are two types mainly we are going to apply. One is called elimination approach method and penalty approach method. So based on this, we are going to solve the problem. See, in elimination approach means, first we are going to solve the problems using a elimination approach boundary condition method. So in this, what they are going to do, in this method, after apply the boundary condition, the row and column corresponding to the known value of the field variable is eliminated. Means which are the field variable? Suppose I know what are the forces acting at node, which node, and where it is fixed. Which are the field variables I know, displacement variable or load variable I know, that we need to go into eliminate corresponding rows and column. How it will be? So that is better way to explain when you are going to solve the problem. That will become very easy to understand. So that will take up directly the problems. Then I will explain it there only directly. Otherwise it may confuse for you. So that is means what you are going to do, what which are the known values is there, corresponding rows and nodes we are going to eliminate. That's all. How we'll see in the problem. So therefore, a penalty method we'll see later. First we are going to solve the problems on the elimination method, then we go for penalty method. Out of these two, very easiest one, boundary condition method is elimination approach method. Elimination approach method. So therefore, so let me see that what are the steps involved in this solving this 1D bar elements. So this is very, very important. All of you take a note now. On all of you. Hello? Hello? Who is that? Nayamtula, please mute yourself. Hello? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now, all of you, write down the heading. Yes, sir. Steps involved in the 1D bar elements or 1D bar problem. All of you, clearly note down. This is very important. Step number one. Write the finite element model for a given continuum. Means, what are the geometric model they given? That is called continuum. That we need to convert into FEM model. This nodes are converted, so points are converted into nodes, lines are converted into elements. That we need to write a FEM model. That is the first step. Written. Next step.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Next step, what you have to do, determine the eliminate stiffness matrix for the each individual element. That means, for each individual element, we need to find what are the values of k1, k2. That is depend upon the number of elements. If two elements means only k1, k2 or else 3. So that is a formula you know well. K is equal to, just now we derived, A, E by L, 1 minus 1 minus 1. That is a formula. That is the second step. Third step, what you have to do is, third step. Once you find the individual stiffness matrix, what is the next step you have to do? We need to assemble it. That is global stiffness matrix we need to find. That is capital K is equal to sum of the individual element matrix, stiffness matrix, K1, K2, like that. So here we written a small E, know, E stands for element. E stands suffix, E stands for element. That is the third step, determination of global stiffness matrix. That is K is equal to sum of individual stiffness matrix. Is it over?
No, sir.
No, sir.
ओवर
कॉम्प्लीट
ओवर नाउ इट इज क्लियर. और स्टेप नंबर थ्री.
सर
नेक्स्ट स्टेप नंबर फोर. व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, वी नीड टू डिटरमाइन द ग्लोबल डिस्प्लेसमेंट वेक्टर एंड फोर्स वेक्टर. दैट मींस व्हाट आर द नोडल डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज देयर, नो दैट वी नीड टू ऐड इट. दैट इज कॉल्ड ग्लोबल स्टिफनेस वेक्टर फॉर द ईच एलिमेंट एट द ईच नोड and global force vector at the each node. What is the force and the displacement acting at each node? Therefore, so for example, three nodes are there, then q1, q2, q3. That is called capital Q vector. That is called global displacement vector. Suppose if force f1, f2, f3 acting on three node means that if you add it, that will get force, global force vector. So therefore, capital Q vector and capital F vector, that we need to find it. That is the step number four. That is known as determination of global displacement vector and force vector. That is a step number four. Step number four is determination of global stiffness vector and global force vector. That is capital Q and capital F. Next step is equilibrium equation. We need to apply equilibrium condition. What do you mean by equilibrium condition? Means this is the one. That is KQ is equal to F. KQ is equal to F.
What is that? Sorry,
equation for it. Continuum. Hello. Class not there. Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Equilibrium equation for a continuum. Continuum in the sense, what is the model they given? No? That is geometric model. That is called continuum. See, equilibrium equations is KQ is equal to F, where capital K is nothing but what? Capital K is nothing but global stiffness matrix, Q is nothing but global displacement vector, and capital F nothing but force vector. That KQ is equal to F. What it indicate means, this is my applied force. This is my applied force. So how much force is applying, thus much resistance going to be created in the member or body itself. That resistance value will be stiffness times of displacement at each node will be there. So if these two values are equal, then there will be a equilibrium in the force or body. Otherwise, it not be. That is the thing. So what is this KQ will be contains? That is the next step we are going to take it. Right. See, here, so this K indicates the property. That means stiffness property. This U indicates the behavior. This F indicates the action. Means you are going to apply the force. That is action. For that, how it will be behave? Nodes are how it will behave. Or member, how it will be behave? That is known as displacement vector. How, because of action of the force, how much it is going to be displaced? That is known as behavior it indicates. And K indicates the what is the stiffness of property of that member. That is the things. So suppose, what are the properties means? Suppose here, suppose you take an elastic member, thermal, suppose elastic body of the application member, thermal body is there. That means thermal application problem, fluid application problem, elastostatic. In case of that, what is the K will be is, so in case of elastic body or elastic problem, stiffness is the property K. And thermal, the property of K is conductivity. And for fluid, it is viscosity. And elastostatic, it is dielectric permittivity. This is the K property will be there. And behavior comes to, suppose if a structural problem, elastic means is a structural problem, then the behavior will be displacement. suppose in case of thermal problem, the behavior is temperature. Suppose in case of fluid, the behavior is velocity. Suppose in case of electrostatic, the behavior is electropotential. Next one is action. What are the action? Suppose in case of structural force, we are going to apply a force is the action. Thermal heat source is a action force. Fluid body force is a action force. Electrostatic charge is elastic. So this is about that. Understand? Understood?
Yes, sir.
Please write down this. Very important. You will not get it in textbook or anywhere. This one. Please write down this. So means okay, depend upon okay, the application of problem, it will be changed. K property for the structural problem is stiffness, thermal problem conductivity, fluid problem viscosity, and elastostatic is dielectric permeability. And for the behavior, U matrix, again, structural problem displacement, thermal problem temperature, fluid problem velocity, and elastostatic electric potential. No need to mark it. Just for understand purpose, this is called unknowns. See, actually, what they given in the problem is this is known. They will give K also, they will give properties of the material also give. What you have to calculate is only the U. That is called unknown. That's why they mark it here separately. The written as unknown. So similarly, for a structural problem, the action is force, thermal problem heat source, fluid problem body force, and electrostatic it's a charge. This is very important one concept. Q is equal to F means what means? K indicates property, U indicates behavior, F indicates the action. Now, 1D bar element we are discussing, it comes under which type of problem? Structural problem or non-structural problem? 1D bar element, what it? Type of problem, structural or non-structural types of problem? Hello? Hello?
Yes sir.
1D bar element, no? 1D bar. It's a structural problem or non-structural problem?
Structural, sir.
Structural, sir.
Then what is K indicates there? Then what is K indicates?
Global.
K indicates what is the property here? Stiffness. And what is U indicates?
Stiffness.
What is U indicates in this case?
Displacement.
And action is force.
Force.
Now we are deal with the only this one, structural now, in this module. That's what. So that is the indicates. So only unknown is here, you have to calculate at the each node. These two are they will give knowns in the problem they will give. Okay, next one. Over this one. Over?
No, sir.
See, you don't worry about my subject. I need to make pass whatever it may be in the condition, it may be online or offline. You don't worry about that. So I will make it to understand, I will make it to pass. But the thing is, without your coordination or without your effort, it not be possible. One way it is not possible. So I will also put effort, and you should put more effort than me.
Okay.
Let it. We are going to repeat n number of times. No problem. We'll take more classes. No
okay,
problem.
Okay.
But you have to be over.
Four. Yes, sir.
What is the next step after the equate to this equilibrium condition? Or then what you have to next step is what you have to do is we need to apply the boundary condition. As I told earlier, there are two types of boundary condition. Either you have to use elimination approach or by penalty approach you have to use. But now we are solving the problem with elimination approach. So how to solve it using elimination approach? When you're solving the problem, you can get more. So once you applied this boundary condition, what is the step number 7 is? Write down step number 6, you write down all of you. Over step number 6.
Over, sir.
This is penalty. PENALTY. This is T. Y. Now, in step number 7, finally, we need to find the stress, strain, or reaction unknowns. So, now that is what here. After the apply the boundary condition, we are going to determine the stress and strain like this. What is the formula? Stress is equal to E into B into Q. Again, B means what? That is strain displacement matrix. That value is 1 by L E minus 1, 1 and Q. See, either they are going to use some textbook capital Q or small Q. Capital U. Sorry, capital Q or small U. Okay. Here. In place of Q, no? That is they are going to use. KQ or KU, some textbook. So, yeah, 1 minute. So, here, I think you. So, I said here KQ is equal to F, but they written here. In some other textbook, there is in U. So, in place of U, you can write it as Q. Here, Q. Here also Q.
Okay,
U or Q, both are same. U or Q, both are same.
Okay.
Don't confuse. Some textbook, they are going to use U or some textbook, they are going to use Q. Majorly, they are going to use Q, most of the textbook. That's why written as Q here. So, here also you make it KQ, not U, make it Q. It might not avoid the confusion. Now, strain. If you want to find the strain, B into Q formula. Again, B means, you know, is K, Q is nothing but global displacement matrix. Global displacement matrix. Next, finally, step number 8 is the, suppose, if you want to find the reaction. The problem, they say, up to only stress strain strain means up to six, step number 7. Suppose if you want to find reaction also means, then you have to find the reaction. How? R is equal to KQ minus F. So, what is the equilibrium equation there? No, KQ is equal to F. If F transferred to the left hand side, and what is that value will get it as a reaction. So, these are the totally step number 8 steps are there in order to solve the entire problems on this 1D bar element. Almost the same type of steps is applicable for all the types of problem actually. It may be truss, it may be same type, only formula will be changed. But steps almost it is same. That's why I said FEM problems are very easy to do it. Because almost same pressure, only the formula is different. That's all. That we are going to use. It. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, this 8 step you have to memorize. When you are going to solve the problem, automatically it becomes memorized. That means you will become very familiar. No need to mug up also. So, now, before going to solve the problem, so make first every module what we need to do before going to do the problem. We make a list of the formula because without the formulas, it is not possible to solve the problem so that we know that. So, let us write down list of formulas. In separate sheet, you write list of formulas. So that means we'll give the formulas one by one that you have to memorize during the problems. What are the extra new formulas is there that you have to note on there. So let us see first what is the thing you have to write in the list of formula. Let's turn the beginning. I think write down shape function for the shape function for the 1D bar element with respect to the natural, sorry, Cartesian coordinate system. This is what n1 equal to x2 minus x divided by le, n2 equal to x minus x divided by le. This is the one formula you know done. This is known as shape function for the 1D bar element with respect to which coordinate system? With respect to which coordinate system? Shape function with respect to which coordinate system? Just now I said
Cartesian.
Right on. Anyway, we are not much going to use in the problem, but anyway, equation you have to memorize because that is also required for the derivation. No, finally, you have to write this prop equation. That is what you have to memorize the final expressions. Over. Over. Next. Same. Next, what we derive? Shape function for a natural coordinate system. What is the formula? N1 into What is the formula of n1 into? N1 is 1 minus zeta divided by 2. N2 is 1 plus zeta divided by 2. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
And what we derived? Strain displacement matrix that you already written, I think. So that is B is equal to strain displacement matrix formula. This is very important. This and all. B is equal to 1 by LE into 1 by LE into minus 1, 1. And stress, I think you already written that formula, no? Somewhere now, here itself you written. That is only you can rewrite once again. Stress is equal to E into B into Q. Strain is B into Q. Strain is B into Q. And reaction. Again, you write in the formula list. R is equal to KQ minus F. R is equal to KQ minus F. KQ minus F. Over.
Yes, sir.
Next, stiffness matrix. What we derived? That also you write. K is equal to AE by L. 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. Stiffness matrix for the element is AE by L 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. How many it's become now? Formula?
10, sir.
10, sir.
10. Now, here the F is there, no? Force vector. This force vector again going to be changed with respect to the types of load, like it may be axial load, it may be a uniform load like that. So leave the space, any extra formula will comes when you are going to do the problem, that we are going to add it in the list. Leave some space to write the formula. When during the solving the problem, we are going to add any extra formula it comes, that you have to note down there. I will say, which is the extra new formula will come, that time I will say, you should note down here in the formal list. Okay.
Okay, sir.
All of you got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, well, let us start the first numerical part in the FEM. Till now, we have not solved the problem itself. We are going to take the first problems on the numerical and the 1D bar element. It's a compulsory question. They will most of the time they will ask you either 1D bar element, one problem will come, or truss element will come. Both are in the same module. So very important. Again, here there are different cases are there. So how in MOM it is there, no? Like uniform bar, stepped bar, taper bar, self-weight problem. In the same way here also, we are going to take up the bar with different end conditions, with a uniform bar, stepped bar like that, and different load conditions. Like it may be axial load, it may be UDL load, or it may be a self-weight, or it may be a thermal load, thermal stresses problem. That also it will comes here. So therefore, for each cases, we need to see how it will be the going to solve the problem, that we are going to take it. So in that first case, we are taking, write down, numerical problem using that two. There are two boundary conditions, as I said, elimination approach, penalty approach. Now we are going to solve the problems on elimination approach, not penalty. Penalty will take it next. So let us start with the numerical problem using elimination approach. See, one, two, three problem, I will slowly will solve. After that, what I will do, I will explain the procedure. I will tell you to take the screenshot of that. Then you have to write down and solve it yourself after that. Okay. One, two, three problem will solve directly here.
Okay.
Solve live.
Okay,
after that, I will explain you the procedure, because once you familiar, two, three problem become familiar, it is very easy to you to understand. That's why I will just explain the procedure, how to solve it and all. And you take the screenshot of that solution of the problem, then you can solve yourself and note down in the notes. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Same procedure.
almost all same procedure. All everything same procedure. Only for the load condition, the formula will somewhat changes. That's all. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Only one.
Okay, sir.
Okay. For in that first case, we are taking write down heading. This is the main heading. In that first case number one, uniform bar with a axial load means uniform bar in the sense area is uniform. Area is uniform. It will not change. So with the axial load, either it may be compression or it may be a tensile. They are going to use axial. What do you mean by axial force means? What do you mean by axial force? What do you mean by axial force?
Along the axis. Along the axis of.
Yes, force acting along the axis. Keep this in mind. Okay, let us take the first problem. You can see this first problem. I think you can write down the figure. So most of the problem they will give the figure, so you can write down that. So the bar shown in figure subjected to axial loading. We need to find what is the nodal displacement. We need to find what is the stress, and we need to find what is the reaction at the support. So what is the figure? They given one bar, it fixed at here. Freeze at the right hand side. They apply the axial tensile force that is 10 kN. It's having a length 1000, and Young's modulus is 200 GPa, and having a area 10 to the power of 4 millimeter to the power of 4. All are there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Once it over, tell me quickly, please write down.
Sir, find the nodal.
Sir, find the nodal displacement.
Find the.
What is find that? The.
Find the nodal displacement. First question.
Okay.
Second question: okay. Stress in okay. Each element and reaction at the support.
Sir, E is equals
to 200
GPa, gigapascal.
Okay.
Okay. A is equal to 10 to the power of 4, mm to the power of 4. And load is 10 kN. Length is 100,000. Over.
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
No, sir.
Make it fast. Work part.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Updates.
Updates.
Yes, sir. Completed.
Take a screenshot also. Suppose if you may be missed, means you can able to see. Oh, okay, take a screenshot. Okay. That's better.
Over, sir.
Over, sir. Over.
Any doubts, you can go through that screenshot. That's all. Next. So we need to solve this one. So first step is, as you know, in any numerical problem, we need to write a data. Okay. So without that, it will not possible. That you know well, correct? So what is the data? What are they given? They given area. That is 10 to the power of 4 millimeter to the power of 4. And they what they given? 210 GPa. What do you mean that 210 GPa means? 210 GPa is what? Material property. Young's modulus. Young's modulus they are given. Correct? Young's modulus. How to convert into gigapascal? Gigapascal to everything we are going to convert into here. Mm. How to convert into gigapascal to Newton per mm square?
210 per mm.
1 sir, GPA is what?
Sir, in the problem, in the diagram, the diagram,
200 GPA.
1 minute.
In the diagram.
Yeah. 1 minute. I'll verify. I got it. Your question, Mike. Yeah, it is not 210, it is 200 only. Sorry. Make a correction. This is not 210, this is 200 only. They're given correct 200 GPA only. Thank you. So this is not 210 GPA, it is a 200 GPA only. Therefore, 1 GPA is equal to how many Newton per mm square? It is 10^3. That you know, very familiar, no? All these things. Because you've done DME and all. And megapascal is given. What is 1 megapascal equal to? Not megapascal, sorry. MPa. What is 1 megapascal equal to? How many times of Newton per meter square?
1
megapascal equal to how many times of Newton per meter square is there?
One Newton.
Yes, 1 megapascal is nothing but 1 Newton per mm square. Keep this in mind. So therefore, it is nothing but 200 × 10^3 Newton per mm square. I can write it as 2 × 10^5 Newton per mm square to make it easy. Okay. So and length is given. Again, it is 1000 mm. 1000 mm. P is equal to 1000 Newton. How much Newton force given? Force is 10 kilonewton. So everything kilonewton, again we need to convert into a Newton.
That per is length.
Per length. Different.
One minute. What?
In diagram, length is 1000
only. So they are written here. It is 1000 mm only and force also 10 kilonewton only. 10 kiloton. 10 kiloton means we need to convert into Newton. 10 × 10^3. See, this is the correct. I think I made. Okay. So this is the data is over. You written all of your data. All of you written the data.
Right.
I said no. I will solve live. Means same thing like in an offline class. So I will explain you. You have to write it yourself and you have to calculate the things. All of you written the data. As per the sketch only, you write it the data. L equal to 1000 mm. F is equal to 10 × 10^3 Newton. And E is equal to 200 GPa is there. Therefore, 2 × 10^5 Newton per mm square. Okay. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Let's begin with the problem now. You have to follow the steps. 8 step. What is the first step in the 1D bar element I given? First step is to what are the given domain is there that we need to convert into FEM domain or FEM model. Means element nodes are converted, points are converted into nodes, lines are converted into elements. So here usually see, this is the uniform bar. Therefore, I will just divide into only one element because your area is everywhere same. Therefore, I am going to divide into only one element but two nodes. At the each end, at the left and here, I will divide into two nodes. So that I am going to do it. I done here. So that is what I written the figure. See, here the one indicates one element. Always element number are indicated by with a round circle. In a circle inside, they will write the element number. And here nodes are here. Here one node and two node. And having a length of the element is LE. And here Q1. And here Q2, that is nodal displacement at the each node. Similarly, the nodal forces are here F1, F2. So this is called FEM model. What we shown the given figure is geometric model. We need to convert into FEM model. Means we need to divide into elements. Now we divide into one element with having a two node. That is 1D bar element we divided. We are used here 1D bar element. Got it? Got it?
Yes, sir.
Step number 2. What is step number 2? Once you done the FEM model, you have to calculate the what? What you have to calculate? Individual stiffness matrix. Element, that is element stiffness matrix. You have to find. So here there are two, only one element is there. Therefore, only one K you have to calculate. That is K1. That is, we know the formula, no? Step number 2. Element stiffness matrix K1 is equal to A1 E1 by L1. 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. So, what is A1? Already you know. What is E1? Already you know. 2 into 10 raised to 5. L1 is, I know already, 10 raised to 3. That you have to substitute. That you have to substitute. Do it. Over. Hello. Hello,
sir.
Stiffness matrix is over. See, and one more thing I need to say here. See, when you're going to calculate the stiffness matrix, no, what is the thing you have to use entire in FEM? What they will do? Stiffness matrix usually value will be very high. So therefore, what they will the calculate the value in terms of 10 raised to the power of 10 will be there. So like what they will do, if you simplify this, what is the value you will get? 2 into 10 power 6. Correct, no? Because 10 power 3, 10 power 5 get cancelled. What is the thing you will get? 2 into 10 power 6. Correct, no? 2 into 10 power 6 you got.
10
power.
Yes, sir.
Correct, yes, sir. No? So yes, what they will yes, usually sir. Will you do, in order to avoid the complications in the calculation, they will not multiply entire 2 into 10 power 6 inside. So what they will do, they will 10 power value will be there, no? That they will keep outside, and rest of the minimum value they will multiply the inside. That means that here 10 power 6 is more compared to 2, no? Therefore 10 power 6, all the 10 power 6 value, it may be 10 power 5 or 10 power 1 or 10 power 12. Those value they will keep outside the matrix. Only remaining term you will multiply the inside the matrix. That means 2 will be there, no? That 2 I multiplied here. 2 into 1, 2. 2 into minus 2, minus 2. Minus 2, minus 2. Even you can multiply here 10 power 6. But why they are not multiplied means calculation become, in order to calculate, no? So that will take more time and become a bit complicated. In order to avoid the complication in the calculation, the greater the values of 10 power, they will keep outside always. And remaining term is there, no? That will multiply the inside to make it easy to calculate. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
All of you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Here, 2 into 10 power 6, what we got, they will not multiply 2 into 10 power 6. Because when you do the global matrix, no? That become bit complications. Everywhere 10 power 6 common, no? That's why they will take 10 power 6 common. So that greater the value they keep outside, later the simplification, finally they are going to multiply that value. So that is they will do in entire FEM. That's why 10 power 6 they keep outside. And here, and one more thing I need to say, here you always write the node number. The element 1, it is belongs to 1 and 2, no? Please write down. Row number is 1 and 2, and in column also give 1 and 2. Here I have not written, but you write it. You follow it that. Write down here in above the matrix 1 2 1 2. Above the matrix you write, not within the matrix. Therefore, I find out the individual stiffness matrix. Third step is what? We need to assemble the global stiffness matrix. Here only one element, we got only K. Therefore, my K1 is nothing but capital K. My K1 is nothing but capital K because only one element, no? Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
There is no K2, K3 here. I have only one K1. Therefore, K1 is nothing but global stiffness matrix, K. That is nothing but I know already 10 power 6, 2 minus 2 minus 2, 2. Here, 1, 2. Please write down the number, node numbering this one. Here, column and row, give the numbers. 1 2 1 2. Next, what is the next step? Step number 4. Step number 4.
Force vector.
Global force.
We need to find the global stiffness displacement vector and force vector. So that is the thing we have to do it. Now, Okay. So step number 4, global force vector. How many forces are there? Only two forces, because you have two nodes.
F1,
F2. Always these are vector, they're calling means it is always, it's a column matrix. That's why written at in a column, in a square, not square matrix, square bracket they're used. They will use the, what is type of bracket this one? What type of bracket this one?
Flower bracket.
All this vector, they will represent in a flower bracket. Keep this in mind. So which is the, this matrix they're going to use, K is a square bracket. So here F1 and F2, because two nodal forces. So here you can see the, come to the figure, observe here, what is any, what is the force acting at point here? What is the force acting here?
Zero.
What is the force acting at here? F at node 2, what is the force?
10 kilo.
Therefore F1 is zero, whereas F2 is 10 into 10 raised to 3. So again here also please write down the node numbering here, here 1 and it is, and here column is 1, but there are 2 rows. Please write down these numbers. It better you write the row number and column number with a different color pen, either red pen or it may be a pencil, you write it, not to avoid the confusion. That's it. Next, global fact. Force vector is over. All of you done?
Over, sir.
Sir, why can't we write F1 is equal to -10?
See, why means, the node 1 means here, node 2 means here. At node 2 only we applied the force, they given the force as 10 kiloton. But here there is no force, they given applied force. It is 0. Reaction is there, but applied force they are not given, no? Given data, that's why. That's why F1 is 0. Global force vector is over, all of you written this one?
Written, sir.
Return, sir.
Next, in the same step, what is the next one? Global displacement vector. That is capital Q. That is nothing but here, you come to the FEM model. The node 1, the displacement, nodal displacement is Q1. At node 2, nodal displacement is Q2 or U1, U2. In some test book, they will use it. Same thing. So this is Q1. Q2, again it is form of vector column matrix. So write on the number in a flower bracket, you have to write it Q1, Q2. And what is Q1, Q2? Q1, Q2 is unknown. We don't know because of force, how much it is going to displacement, that is we don't know, that only we need to calculate. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I told here, no, always in most of the problem, the unknowns are always this global displacement vector or Q vector, whereas F and K is given usually in the problem. That is what. Now Q1, Q2, you don't know. That's why you keep as it is, Q1, Q2. We need to calculate that. Over?
Over, sir.
Over, sir.
Yes, all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Now?
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
What is the next step? Can you tell me what is step number 5? Can you read it and tell me? I given a procedure, no? You written. Step number 5 is what?
Equilibrium equation.
Equilibrium equation.
I need to use, apply the equilibrium condition. That is KQ is equal to F. Correct, no? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
KQ is equal to F. What is K? Capital K. What is capital Q? Capital F. You know that you have to substitute. Capital K is nothing but 10 power 6, 2 minus 2 minus 2, 2. Capital Q is nothing but Q1, Q2. Capital F is nothing but 0 and 10 into 10 raised to 3. That you have to substitute. Apply the equilibrium condition. over?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What is the next condition? Next step. What is next step?
Boundary.
Apply the boundary condition. There are two methods. One is penalty and elimination method. But we are going to use here only elimination method. First one method we are using. So therefore, so here very careful. Please listen properly, all of you. Apply the boundary condition using elimination method. So what you have to do is, means how you have to apply. Please listen carefully. Since node 1 is fixed. Who is that? Mute yourself. Since node 1 is fixed, therefore, nodal displacement at corresponding point is 0. That is Q1 is 0. Hence, eliminate for corresponding rows and column, that is first row and first column. Did you understand what is meaning that? See, that means that here, which node is fixed? Node 1 or node 2? Even
false.
Node 1 is fixed means it is completely fixed. Therefore, there is no displacement along X or Y or Z. Correct? No. So, therefore, your nodal displacement at this node is Q1. It is completely become 0. Because it is 0. Fixed. Are you getting? Hello? That's why using a boundary condition, what you have to do, no? Corresponding rows and column, we need to eliminate. How to that? You can see. Take this equilibrium condition, you rewrite once again. This equation. 1 minute. Yes. So you rewrite this equation once again. And first row, first column, because why first row, first column is Q1 belongs to first row and belongs to year 1, first column. Correct? No. Here not written number. I will write the number. 1, here it is 1 and here it is 2. So, Q1 is 0. Therefore, Q1 is belongs to first row and first column. That's why in everywhere we need to eliminate that. Here entire first row you eliminate and first column in the first column is here. Where is the first column? This one. And where is the first column here? In this one. We need to eliminate. So, that is what. So, apply the boundary condition. Since node 1 is fixed, at corresponding point is 0. Therefore, Q1 is 0. Hence, eliminate corresponding rows and column. That is first row and first column. Are you getting? Not this one. One minute. I will erase all the things. Yeah. First row, first column. Like this. See. What do you mean? That means very important here only. And very easy also. So where it is fixed, Q1 is fixed. That node 1 is fixed. Therefore, there is no displacement at the node 1. Therefore, corresponding nodal displacement at node 1 is Q1. Therefore, Q1 is 0. Therefore, corresponding Q1. It is belongs to first column. Therefore, first row and first column, you have to eliminate like this. So, therefore, here first row, first column eliminated. What is the remaining thing will be there? That we need to solve it. That is 10 power 6. 10 power 6 into 2. That is, and what is the thing is there? Q2 is equal to, as it is, 10 into 10 power 3. First row, first column, we eliminated. First row, first column, we need eliminated. And remaining, what is the term is there? Then that we are written. And here only Q2 is unknown. Therefore, you can easily solve. Q2 is equal to 10 into 10 power 3 divided by 2 into 10 power 6. Then if you solve it, then you will get Q2 as 0.005 mm. All of you understanding what I am saying?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Because of here, anyway, second problem, third problem, if you do it, you become very familiar. Elimination approach. So, since node 1 is fixed, no. Therefore, first row, first column, you just eliminate. The first row, first column is this one. Entirely eliminate. And remaining term, you write as it is. 2 into 10 power 6. Don't forget the 10 power 6 outside the matrix, that value you have to write it. Into Q2 is left and here 10 into 10 power 3 is left. Therefore, if you solve Q2, do it. How much you'll get? Q2, how much you'll get? Solve it.
0.005
mm. Please keep this in mind. Displacement, it is a vector quantity. No force, it's a vector quantity. Units are very important. Everything we calculate in terms of mm here, that's a displacement in terms of mm. All of you got 0.05? The 0.005 or what?
0.005.
All of you got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All of you, all 25 members are there, no? All of you got it?
Sir.
Okay. What is the next step? Can you tell me? Next step.
Determination.
Stress and strain. That is the next step, no? That is what we have to do. Determine the stress and strain. So what is the formula? Stress and strain. First, we need to find the strain. Because if you want to find the stress, we should know strain. That's why. We know strain is equal to B into Q. Again, B is means what? Strain displacement matrix. That is 1L minus 1, 1. And Q. Here, Q is not Q1, Q2. It's just Q means it is a global displacement vector. So that is Q1 and Q2 will be there. Now what you have to do is, we know Q1, it is 0. Q2, we already know no Q2 here, 0.005. That you have to substitute. 1 minute. Hey Google, switch on plug 1.
Sure, turning the plug 1 on.
Okay. See, here, we have to multiply L, substitute all the unknowns values, known value. L is I know 1000, Q1 I know 0, Q2 I know 0.005. Now what you have to do, you have to simplify the things. So here these two matrix should be multiplied. This into this, minus 1 into 0, 0. 1 into 0.005 plus 0.005. Now you have to simplify this. Do it. All of you understand here, step number 7. Hello. Okay. How much? 5 into 10 power minus. What is the unit of strain? What is the unit of strain?
No units.
See, one more thing. See, when you are going to solve the numerical problem, no? What is the method you have to use it, no? The presentation is very important. For each answer, please put a box. So that will clearly indicate the answers. When you are, we are the evaluator, we are looking only the answers, not much steps for all. What is the step by step you are not going to see. We are going to see the only the answers. If answer is correct, no. If you done mistakes inside also, you're not going to see. This is what happened really in the video. So that is the things you have to write it properly, the answers. Okay, next. What is the next step? Okay, stress, so strain over. But we need to calculate stress. Yeah. How to calculate the stress? Can you tell me? How to calculate the stress?
B into Q.
B into?
Q into.
Or one more very easy way can calculate. Now, why you have to multiply B? Stress is equal to, apply the Hook's law. E into what? Into what?
L.
Either you can use E into B into Q, or if you know Young's modulus, directly you can multiply the strain. That you will get directly. So, that is 2 into 10 power 5, you know. That is Young's modulus strain I already calculated. Therefore, stress we got 1. So, stress is we got 1. Finally, the body under which type of stress? The body under which type of stress? Compression or tensile?
Tensile, sir.
Yes, because positive 1 we got. That's why we got, it is tensile. T, I written in bracket. T stands for tensile. What is the final step? First question is over. No doubt discussion is over. Second question is over. Stress and strain. Third question is reaction. We have to find. So, how to find the reaction? R is equal to KQ. See, one more. Where the reaction will be there? Reaction always at the support. That is at the node 1. We need to find. Yes. Because that is fixed. That's well. So, therefore, R is equal to KQ into F. You know, R means it's a reaction vector. That is R1 and R2. And K is global stiffness matrix, that I know. Q is global displacement matrix, I know. F is global force vector, I know. That is F1, F2, Q1, Q2. So, here, Q1 I know already, substitute the value 0. Q2 I know already, 0.005. F1 I know already, that is 0, you substitute. And F2 I know, the given 10 kiloton, that you substitute. And next up, we need to solve it here. R1 is 0 or R2 is 0? Can anyone tell me? R1 is 0 or R2 is 0?
R2 is 0.
No. So therefore, we can directly eliminate this. We can directly write R2 is 0. Only R1 you have to calculate. R1 you have to calculate. How to calculate R1? Can anyone tell me? You multiply the first this one. Simplify this. First row you take it. Second rows for R2. First row, what is the value you'll get? That is for R1. So that you have to do it. How to solve it? Multiply the this first 2 into 0, 0 minus 2 into 0.005 into 10^6. That you have to multiply. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Do it. Check out how much R1 all of you getting minus 10 into 10^3 newton. Check out all of you.
Yes, sir.
So minus 10 into 10^3.
All of you got that value?
Minus 10 into 10^3.
Yes, sir.
R2, if you want, you can calculate. Otherwise, no need to calculate. Direct, you can write 0. Because according to the figure, we can say it is 0. Correct, no?
Sir.
If you calculate also, you get 0 only. You can do it. You can get it. So, this is got the first problem solution. It's completed. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All of you got clear this first problem, numerical part problem on the body
bar.
Yes, sir.
Same steps. Only the what will change? No. It may be values of boundary condition going to change. Or load type it going to change like that. So second case. So first one is the uniform bar with axial load. What is the second type of load is? So case number 2, write down heading. Uniform bar with the uniform load.
Uniform bar.
Uniform load, nothing but UDL load. That is one. Uniform everywhere, it is applied the uniform load. Like uniformly distributed load. That is a case number 2. See, if you see the textbook, what happened, you know? So textbook, almost they will do directly. They will not show you every step. That's why, if you follow my notes, no. This step will be clearly written. That's why. So please maintain the notes properly. That is very important. Okay. Let me take the second problem. Is bar with shown in figure subject to uniform load. That is P naught. 100 Newton meter. Not Newton per meter. It is Newton meter. 100 Newton meter. And E is equal to 70 GPa. And area is 10^4 mm². So determine the nodal displacement and stress. Only 2 questions. No reaction. You have to find it. Nodal displacement, Q1, Q2, and stress, we have to find it. That's all. So they given P naught. You can see in the figure, they given uniform bar. Again, it is fixed here, and here the displacement is X, and this indicate, this arrow indicate everywhere the P naught is applied, that is uniform load, that is 100 Newton meter, and length of this bar is 1200 mm. Got it? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
See, what we are going to do is here is, what are the uniform load is given or any other type, we need to convert into axial force only. How to convert? Now you can write in the formula list, all of you. Open the formula list page, all of you. So this total axial force is always P naught times of L divided by 2. Half of will be there. P naught into L divided by 2. Write down. In the formula list, all of you, total axial force is F is equal to P naught L by 2. In formula list page, you all of you write that. That's why I told you to leave some space to write any extra formulas. Addition formula will come. You have to write down there. All of you written?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. The first step is you have to write the data. What is the data given? P naught. P naught is how much? 100?
Newton per meter.
Not Newton per meter. It is
Newton.
I strike this one. Newton meter. Newton meter to convert into Newton mm multiply by 1000. That is nothing but 100 into 10 power 3 Newton mm, or we can say 1 into 10 power 5 Newton mm. Right now, 1 into 10 power 5 Newton mm. Similarly, 70 GPa convert into Newton per mm square. That is 70 into 10 raised to 3 Newton per mm square. And area, they given in mm square only, no need to convert. And length also they given in mm only, that is 1200 mm. This is the data given. Is it clear? Data written?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Over.
Yes. No, sir.
Over.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, let's go to the first step. What is the first step? First step what?
Finite element model.
Finite element model.
Model. Means now this one, I'm going to divide it. How many number of elements you have to divide now? Again, it is uniform bar and loads also it is uniform. So that's why you divide again into only one element. So see here, that is a finite element model. Here, how to write this FEM model means one element, two nodes, here nodal displacement Q1, Q2. Now it is uniform load, no? So I think this is the indication of uniform load. I think you know this one, no? Symbol. Hello?
Yes, sir.
You know, sir. Uniform load or like UDL type of load, you can ask using this one, no? That is what this notation. All of you getting?
Yes, sir.
What is the second step? Step number two.
Stiffness matrix.
Individual stiffness matrix. Again, here only one element, therefore only one stiffness matrix. Therefore, A1 is equal to A1, L1, E into 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. See, don't write E1 because already only one element and Young's modulus is made up of only one Young's modulus. That's why I rightly write it as E. So 1 minus 1 minus 1. And again, I am not written the number here. Please give the number here. That is very important. I understand purpose, I am not written actually. But you have to write it is. What is the number you have to write? Node numbers, row and column numbers. So how many nodes are there? 2. One element belongs to 2. Therefore, row number 1, 2, 1, 2. Now, what is the A1 value substitute? What is E value substitute? What is the L value substitute? Now, again, I told what is the, you simplify this and in power in terms of 10 power 5, no, that value you keep outside and remaining value multiply inside. So, if you simplify this, I think you will get this one. You can calculate, verify the answer anyway. If any mistakes, will correct it. 10 power 4 into 10, 70 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 1200. How much you got? Even if you value every
3 into 10 power 5.
How much? 58 alla 5.8 into 10 power 5 no?
Yes sir.
5.8. See, even you can multiply entire value here 10 power 5 also, but that bit of complications sir. Not avoid that 10 power 5 we keep outside and remaining 5.83 you multiply by inside. Understood? Hello?
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Please write the numbers here. 1, 2, 1, 2. I'm not written, you write it. Over.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
How many don't have calci? Can you tell me? How many don't have calci? Hello? Hello? Who is that? See, if you simply write it by saying that, no use. You had to arrange yourself, that I already told in the beginning class. So otherwise you will only the going to be face the problem. So you have to arrange, you have to buy it or somewhere to from take from others, I don't know, but you have to arrange the calci as soon as possible. Already numerical part going to start in every module in all subjects. So otherwise it make difficult for you. You have to calculate yourself, till that you will not get know that. Okay, got it? It better to buy now only because lockdown is going to happen. Maybe I don't know your state, I'll straight in and from the Monday. So maybe stalls are open or not, we don't know.
Now it's no, sir.
Huh? Already closed, huh?
Sir, Monday 24th May.
That's why today or tomorrow you try to buy it. Okay. All of you return K value? Hello? This matrix you return all of you. Now, step number 3, determine the global stiffness matrix. So here again, only 1K. That's why that capital K is nothing but capital K1. I have no need to write the value because already we know what is K1. That's why I have not written. Step number 4 is what? Step number 4 is what?
Force vector
and global or displacement vector. First we'll find the force vector or global displacement vector. First we'll calculate the force vector due to distributed load. See here, there is a changes here. I told again the force vector capital F is equal to at each node the nodal forces. Please write the year F1 F2 also. I'm not written actually, you write it in the FEM model figure. All of you write at node 1 F1, at node 2 F2. All of you write it. Therefore, the nodal force vector become F1, F2. But this F1 is a axial force. It's not a distributed force. Therefore, how to convert into axial force? As I told, F1 equal to F2 equal to what?
P0 L by 2.
P0 L by 2. This is very important. Keep this in mind. P0 L by 2. Therefore, here P0 L by 2, here P0 L by 2. That we taken common here. P0 L by 2. Therefore, here what is the left inside the matrix? 1, 1. It is not a square matrix. It is a flower bracket. Got it? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
F1, F2 is nothing but P0 L by 2. Therefore, I taken a common. Therefore, what is left here? 1.
Sir,
what? Tell me.
In previous problem,
K equal to K1. That's all. Here also same.
Above well.
I'm not written because already we know what is K1. No, that's why I'm not written. If you want, you can write it this value. This value you can write it.
Okay.
Why you need to write it? Already I know K1. No, that's why I just avoid the step. That's all. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Now substitute the P0 value. L value, P0 100 into 10 raised to 3, L value 2. Therefore, if you simplify this, you'll get how much? Simplify 60, this, how much 60, you get? 60 into
10 to the power of
16 to 10 power 6. That you multiply the inside the matrix. That is, therefore, the global force vector become 16 to 10 power 6. 16 to 10 power 6. Understand? Hello? Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Sir, sir.
This is one, this is two. Next, global displacement vector. How many global displacements are there? How many nodal displacements are there?
Two, sir.
Here Q1, Q2. Therefore, Q1, Q2. These are unknown, as it is, keep it. What is the next step number 5? Step number 5 is
equilibrium
equation. That is KQ is equal to F. I know K matrix. That is this one, K1 matrix. Q matrix, I know Q1, Q2. I know F matrix, 16 to 10 power 6 divided by 16, and not divided by, sorry, 16 to 10 power 6 and 16 to 10 power 6. In that you have to substitute. So all of you write this one. Copy.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
All of you, are you understanding? You tell me this is the beginning of the problem. Any doubts, you can clear it
yes,
yourself.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Is it okay for you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Concentrate, concentrate. No other way. Over?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What is the next step? Can you tell me what is the next step?
Boundary conditions.
Using a elimination approach. That you have to write it. Write everything like this only. You have to write like this in exam also. Step number 6, apply the boundary conditions using a elimination technique or method. Can you tell me which node is fixed again here?
First one.
Node 1 Q1 is fixed. Q1. Therefore, node 1 is fixed means Q1 becomes 0. Therefore, node Q1 is with respect to the node 1. No? Therefore, first row and first column, you have to what? What you have to do? First row and first column, what you have to do?
Cancel.
You have to eliminate.
Yes.
Eliminate.
Write down that. Since node 1 is fixed, Q1 is 0, hence eliminate the corresponding row and column. That is first row, first column. First row, first column. All right. Okay, you do it. You got it now. So eliminate this. All right. Eliminate first row, first column. Anyway, it is visible. So what is things are left now here? 10 power 5 into 5.883 into Q2 is equal to 16 to 10 power 6. Correct now? Please write the number properly. That I'm not written. I don't have notes here. 1, 2, 1, 2. Okay. Write the numbers properly. Got it? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
What is the value of Q2? Tell me. Calculate yourself. Q2. Tell me.
102.86.
Calculated?
102.75.
Okay, good. So 102 and decimal is maybe varied, depend upon the river, how many decimal you consider. Okay. I got 102.915, no problem. How much you got it? That much only you write it. And final step is, first question is over. Nodal displacement is over. Second question is what? They're saying? Second question is what?
Stress, sir.
That you know. You can find first stress. If you want to find strain first, then you can calculate stress. Or you can directly calculate EBQ also, you can get it. First, I'll calculate the strain. That is B into Q. B is nothing but 1L minus 1, 1, Q1, Q2. Q1 is 0. Q2, I know I got it. 102.915. So then you multiply these two matrix and simplify. What is the strain you get? You check out. All of you check out how much you got. Right. Check out all of you.
Oh, God.
How much train all of you check out? Hello? You are there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
How much strain?
Sir,
0.0875.
Yes, 0.0875. Correct. Final stress become E into epsilon. Sumanth. Hello, Sumantha.
Yes, sir.
Kelsey, arrange Marco.
Sir.
Kelsey, arrange it.
Yes, sir.
Oh, thank
you. Yes, sir.
All of you got stress 6,000.
Yes, sir.
In question, they are not as good actually reaction. If you want, you can calculate. Better you calculate. I already calculated. That is KQ minus. Oh, damn. Okay, fine. I written 9 now. Okay. No problem. You write it 8 only. So that is reaction R is equal to KQ minus F. Yes, it is step number 8, not 9. All of you write step number 8. They are not as good, but let it be. Reaction you calculate again. R1, which is 0, R1 0 or R2 0? Where the reaction will be developed at node 1 or node 2?
R2 0, sir.
R2 0 because it is not fixed, only reaction will be developed at the. So, therefore, you substitute all the values of K, Q, F, and here R vector R1, R2. R2 anyway 0, no need to calculate. R1 only you calculate. All of you calculate R1. In HT subject, my problems are started.
No, sir.
What?
PDF file.
Procedure, I will explain that steps. That you have to take the same thing, screenshot, and you have to do it. Because it takes more time, no? Now, no one is class taking today. That's no problem. Otherwise, it makes problem. Anyway, calculate R1, R2. Like this is okay for you, no? Numerical part, if you do it.
Yes, sir.
RF, is it okay or anything? Any suggestions?
No, sir.
Tell me, what is R1?
Minus 1762.
No, minus 1. code properly. Check out properly. Minus 120 into 6, you have to get it.
Minus 112
into
10
power 6. Minus
112
into 10 How much? Hello? Hello? Hello?
Sir, sir.
Tell me how much you got.
Minus 12 into 10 power 7.
Correct. Answer is right. 120, no? 120 into 10 power 6 or 12 into 10 power 7.
Yes.
Correct. Okay. Hello, if you got it?
Yes, sir.
How we have to verify the reaction, no? I will tell you. See, why reaction will be produced? Can anyone tell me? Why reaction will produce? Anyone tell me? Reaction, why it will be developed?
Because of force.
See, when you are going to apply the force, what happened? No, definitely it is not under equilibrium. It's going to move. Therefore, not to make equilibrium, no, the forces will be acting in opposite direction. Here 10 kiloton is acting, means how much should be acting here to make equilibrium? 10 only, no?
Minus 10.
That is minus 10. So therefore you got in the first problem minus 10. If reaction is equal to applied force, then it is the problem is right, otherwise it is wrong. Like that you can verify. Okay. Here how much you got? 60 plus 60, no? Forces. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Forces we got 60 plus 60. 60 plus 60 become 120. Correct, no? Therefore, the reaction is 120. Understood?
Yes, sir.
All of you get that
yes,
value?
Sir. Yes, sir.
All of you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Let me move to the third problem then. Note on this. Last problem on this session. You got any session?
Java class,
sir. You got it?
What 11th?
Java class is there. You got the link?
No,
Java
sir.
Class?
No, sir.
Do it. I know you, they will not take it. Today is Saturday. No. That's why I planned today. Because I need more time to explain in the live. So all of you copy this.
ಏನು ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ನಡೀತೈತಿ ಏನು ಯಾರು ಕರೆದ್ರು ಏನಂತೀಯ ಏನ ಮಾಡ
ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫೀಲ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ದಟ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ಐ ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ A bar having a uniform cross-section area, 300 mm square, and is subjected to a load of 600 kiloton, shown in figure, determine the displacement field. Displacement field nothing but Q1, Q2, all those things. Stress and support reaction in the bar. Consider two element and use elimination method to handle. See, this is the examination problem, very important. They said clearly, you do the... discretize this element bar into two elements. That's why you need to divide into two. And use the elimination method to handle the boundary condition, they said. And take E is equal to 200 GPa. See, what is the difference between previous problem and this problem? Can anyone tell me?
What is the first difference? Two problem. We have taken only one.
But here...
Here two elements.
Two supports are there, but in that support, this bar, it is such a second gap is there between the support and the bar, 0.1 to m. That is the thing. So P is acting here. That P value they are given, that is which type of force? Again, this one. P is a which type of force?
Uniform.
Not uniform. They are mentioned uniform. Uniform means they will mention clearly with a notation P naught and how much Newton meter mm. But what is the unit of P here? That means axial force. That means this is axial force. Axial tensile force. So the up to here it is 150 mm. Up to here it is 150 mm. So and it is area is 300 mm square. They are given. Figure only they are given. And gap is 0.12. Okay. Now we need to write the data. P is equal to how much? 600 kiloton. Area is how much?
Figure
is 300 mm. Figure
zoom out. Okay, sir.
Clear kanadu. Hing madidre. ಜೂಮ್ ಇನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಸೈಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಓ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಕಾಣಲ್ವಾ ಓಕೆ
ಹೌದೇನು
ಓಕೆ ದ ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ನೋ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಪಿ ಇಸ್ 600 ಏರಿಯಾ ಇಸ್ 300 ಅಂಡ್ ಯಂಗ್ಸ್ ಮನ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ 200 ಇಂಟು 10^3 ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಜಿ ಪಿ ಎಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ನೋಡಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ Not Q1, Q2. We are divided into two element means how many nodes you'll get?
Three nodes.
Q1, Q2, Q3. One more you add it here. Find Q1, Q2 and Q3. Then you have to find stress and finally you have to find the reaction. That is the questions. Kishore, you are here? Kishore. Gautam, Shashank,
Yes, sir.
Okay. Understanding?
Yes, sir.
Okay, first step is you have to write the finite element model. See, they clearly said that divide into two element. So, how to divide means, see, up to the load point one element, up to from P to up to here one more element. Therefore, I divide into two elements. See, is written as in a circle, no? That is a node element number. Therefore, element 1 belongs to node 1 and 2 and belongs to node element 2 is 2 and 3. At node 1, the corresponding nodal displacements are Q1, Q2, Q3 and nodal forces are F1, F2, F3. And up to node 1 to 1 to distance, what is the distance here? What is the distance up to here?
150 mm.
Therefore, L1 is 150, L2 also 150. And the gap is, they given 0.12. From the certain point, that is 0.12 mm. That's lead. What is the second step? Hello?
Stiffness matrix.
What is stiffness matrix? Element stiffness matrix. Here, how many elements stiffness matrix you will get? How many elements stiffness matrix you will get here?
Two elements.
K1, K2. Therefore, you have to calculate K1, K2 separately. Keep this in mind. Till now, only 1K, but now there are 2. So, that is K1 is equal to A1E by L1. E is not E1, E2. Because Young's modulus means it is made up of only one material. It is not a composite. That's why E. A1, L1, E, 1, minus 1, minus 1. But now we have to write the numbers here. So what is the numbering here? Element 1 belongs to how many nodes? What is the nodes it belongs to?
1 and 2.
So now substitute A1 value, E value, L1 value. Check out how much you'll get. (3)/(2)×10^5/150, do it, how much you get?
(4)×10^5/(4)×10^5).
So 4 you multiply inside, 10^5 keep outside. Therefore that is come (+4, -4, -4, +4). This is K1.
Okay.
What is K2 you can get? Any changes in the value L1, A2? E value, any changes in for element 2?
Say L1, sir.
No,
in the element 2, L2 is any changes, A2 is any changes, E value, any changes? Everything is same, no?
Yes, sir.
Area is same length, sir. Therefore, K2 also same thing. If you want, you can calculate, directly you can write. K2 is same thing you'll get. 4×10^5. Correct, no? But belongs to which node? That is very important. Belongs to which node?
2 and 3.
That numbering you have to write it. So here 2, 3. Here 2, 3. I think I written here. So, therefore, finally, global stiffness matrix, that is K1 plus K2. What is the size of the global stiffness matrix? Can you tell me? What is the size of the global stiffness matrix? Size of stiffness matrix, global stiffness matrix, what? Hello?
2 into 2.
2, sir. 2, sir. Why 2 into 2? Size of global stiffness matrix. The global stiffness matrix order depend upon what?
Stiffness matrix.
Stiffness matrix size depend upon what? It is a property, no? I said it. Always the size of the matrix, it depend upon what?
Number of columns.
Veena, Ruchita, you tell me.
Yes, sir.
The size of the stiffness matrix depend upon what? That, just know, I clearly said 3 times that one. Yesterday, today, day after before also. The size of the matrix depend upon number of nodes. Keep this in mind. That is the one first property. How many number of nodes are there?
2 not.
Therefore, the size of the matrix become what?
3 not.
What is the size of the matrix become?
3 rows, 3 columns.
3 rows, 3 columns.
Yes, 3 by 3. 3 into 3. Correct? Keep this in mind. Therefore, you will get 3 rows, 3 columns. How to add it? I told you, no? Global stiffness matrix, how to add it? I explained you, right? Just now. Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I explained you, right? I will explain once again here it's also. Please observe carefully. See, okay. When you're going to add the K, no? First, write the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Column number, row numbers. Now, how to add it? First, you see, in outside the K1, K2, 10 power is 5 is common. Therefore, you write the outside the matter 10 power 5. Next, first row, first column. 1, 1. K1, 1. So, where is the 1, 1? Here. That is how much, what is the value here? What is the value here?
4.
Therefore, write the 4. And here any 1, 1 is there? Not. Next. Second column, first row. 2, 1. Or 1, 2. Like that you usually will call 1, 1, 1, 2. So, hey, where is the 1, 2? Or 2, 1 I can say. That is minus 4. Here, 2, 1. 2, 1 is there, no? Here also. That is minus 4. Next. 3, 1. Any 3, 1 is there?
No
connecting wire. That is 0.
Sir, 0.
Next,
sir,
0. Next come. 1, 2. Where is 1, 2? Here. Minus 4. Next. 2, 2. Yes. 2, 2 is here. 4. And one more. Don't forget. Here 1. And here also one more 2, 2 value is there. That is 4. 4 plus 4? 4 plus 4?
8. 8.
8 into 10 power 5 actually. Anyway, 10 power 5 we kept already outside. Don't worry. Next. 3, 2. 3, 2. Minus 4. Here there is no 3, 2. Only minus 4 is there. Therefore, minus 4. Next. 1, 3. Where is 1, 3? There is no combination of 1, 3. 0. Next. 2, 3. Where is 2, 3? 2. Here 3. That is minus 4. Minus 4. Next. 3, 3. Where is 3, 3? Only one combination. 4. Like that you have to add it. Understood? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The very easiest one more way I will teach you. Shortcut. See, I will write it and show you. Observe here. See what you have to do now? First, write the first matrix. That is like 4 minus 4, 4, 4. Okay. Next, what is the next step you have to do? Next matrix, what is the, it start from 2. So, therefore, here, the 2 is here. Start from here, no? Therefore, what you have to do? Directly, you can add it like this. 4 plus 4 minus 4 minus 4 and 4. Therefore, remaining in these places, it is 0 and is 0. Therefore, you got 4 minus 4, 0, 4, 4 plus 4, 8, minus 4, 0, minus 4, plus 4. Like that, you can easily add it. Principal diagonal element, you add it. That is 2 row number, that is 2, 2 here. From here, you add it like that. Got it? How I written here? Understood,
sir,
no?
Sir.
That is the easiest way you can do it. Are any confusion in this mess? You, as I told here, no, you follow it. Then you will not make any mistakes. All of you written K value, global stiffness matrix, all of you written?
Yes, sir.
All of you written?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Then, global, next step is find the global force vector and find the global displacement vector. So, let us find first global displacement vector. How many nodes are there? How many nodes?
Please.
Therefore, corresponding nodal displacements are Q1, Q2, Q3, unknown. Keep as it is. Now, very important steps. Node global force vector. How many global force vector? 3 nodes? 3. F1, F2, F3. So, here very important thing. There is a changes in the global force vector. This step is very important. Please observe all of you. Stop writing. If you are writing, please stop it. observe properly. So this step is very important. What I written the global force vector? So the global force vector I did written as, see, F is equal to F1 minus K13A3, F2 minus K23A3, F3 minus K33A3. Why I written like this means, please observe, where, what do you mean by A3 means, A3 is nothing but maximum displacement at node. See here in the figure, you observe, what is the displacement maximum it can take? When you apply the force like this, up to the node number 3 is here. Node 3, it will take up to the maximum displacement what? Up to this gap, no? Correct? Hello?
Hello?
Up, when I am going to pull like this, up to 0.12 it can take, it will deform easily. After that it can't be because here there is a constraint. Therefore, this 0.212 is called as, we written as A3. This is called maximum displacement. This is called maximum displacement. So therefore, A3 is 0.12 mm. So therefore, what you have to do is, the changes in the load vector due to presence of minimum gap between the node 3 and fixed boundary. Therefore, the force applied at node 3 will be equal to 0 and reaction will not be equal to 0. See, I will repeat once again. The changes in the load vector due to presence of minimum gap between the node 3 and fixed boundary, that is nothing but this one. That is the minimum gap, node 3 is here and minimum gap they're saying. So minimum gap is 0.12. That is the, so the maximum displacement between node 3 and between the constraint or boundary here, fixed boundary. That is what they're saying, fixed boundary. Therefore, the force applied at node 3 will be equal to 0, but reaction force will not be 0. Here, what is the force acting? It is 0. But because of when you're going to pulling up to 0.12 mm, it can be freely expand. But after that, it can't be. Therefore, there is a reaction going to be take place in this because of support in opposite direction. So therefore, that nodal displacement at node 3 will be Q3 is equal to A3 will be there. How much Q3 will be there? That is A3 will be there. Therefore, that remaining force will be, what we have to do is F1 minus K13. What do you mean by K13? K13 is nothing but this one. This is called K11, K12, K13, K21, K22, K23, K31, K32, K33. So this F1 minus K13 into A3, you have to do it. Similarly, F2 minus K23, third column you take it, K23 minus A3, you have to do it. And F3 will be K33 into F3 minus K33 into A3, you have to do it. So where A3 is nothing but maximum displacement, that is the gap distance, and where K13, K23 and K33 are the stiffness element along the third node. So if you subtract this one, you'll get the global force vector. That is very important, the steps changer. That's why this problem is very important. Two times or three times they're given, because maximum mistake people will do is here. That is the reason. So therefore, you have to calculate like this. So now all of you note on this. Is it clear? Why I'm taking this? Because of the gap, what is the remaining applied force will be the global force will be there. That is it. Write down. All of you copy it. Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Whenever the gap problem is given, no, please, you have to take care of this one. So that gap distance multiply the corresponding node of the stiffness value elements. Subtract from the nodal forces. Once it over, tell me, I will change the slide. Over?
Yes, sir.
All of you over?
Over, sir.
Yes, sir.
Please write the sentence properly. We'll read once again. You can write down the changes in the load vector. The changes in the load vector due to presence of minimum gap between node 3. The changes in the load vector due to presence of minimum gap between the node 3 and fixed boundary. To stop. Therefore, the force at node 3 will be equal to 0, but reaction will not be equal to 0. Because there is a boundary is there, no reaction will be there. And also, the nodal displacement at node 3 become Q3 is equal to how much gap is there, no? That is A3 value, 0.12 mm will be there. Nodal displacement value will be Q3 is equal to, so the node 3 will be move up to the distance of gap 0.12 mm, that is Q3 value. That is step number 4, global force vector. That is the changes. Rest of the things are same. What is the next step number 5?
Equilibrium equation.
So that what we find out KQF value, that we need to substitute in the equilibrium equation. That is KQ is equal to F. Yes, substitute all of you. Please write the numbers, all of you. Here 1, 2, 3. Here 1, 2, 3. Here 1, 2, 3. You do it. Like that, you write it. Love. So F means F1 minus K1 3A3. F2 means F2 minus K2 3A3. And next third one is F3 minus K3 3A3. Wasim came. Wasim, Zebirullah, Wasim.
Yes, sir.
What is the next step? Hello. What is the next step?
Boundary conditions
using elimination method. Can you tell me which row become zero now?
Third row and third column, sir.
See the problem and tell me properly. Where and all it is fixed, that is become zero.
One and first node and third node, no?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
You
yes, sir.
Have to write like this.
Yes, sir.
Fix. Actually, this word is not fixed. Please, here you write properly. This is not a fixed. This word is actually called since. Since node 1 is fixed, this is called since. S-I-N-C. since node 1 is fixed, eliminate the corresponding row and corresponding column, and also node 3 having displacement. See, node 3 is not 0. At node 3, the displacement is not 0. What is the displacement there? What is the displacement at node 3?
0.1.
Here, 0.1. See, up to it can move, up to what distance it can move? Node 3.
0.12.
Therefore, Q3 is not 0. That is 0.12 eliminates there. Therefore, Q1 I know, it is 0. Q3 also I know, that is 0.12. Therefore, eliminate corresponding rows and column. The node 1 belongs to first row and first column. First row, first column, you eliminate it. And Q3 belongs to third row, third column. Third row and third column, you eliminate it. Understand? Why eliminate it too? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Q1, I know, it's completely fixed. That is 0. And one more displacement I know, that is Q3. It will move up to 0.13. Therefore, Q3 value is 0.13. That's why corresponding rows and column you will need. So what is the thing is left now? N power 5 into 8 into Q2 is equal to F2 minus K23 into A3. What is K23 value? Can anyone tell me what is K23 value?
Eight.
What is K23
eight.
Value? Can anyone tell me?
Eight.
K23, how much is the value of K23?
Minus 4.
K23 is minus 4. Good. In stiffness matrix, you can see K23 is here, minus 4. Similarly, what is F2? What is F2? Because I want Q2 means, I should know F2, I should know K23, I should know A3, no? A3 I know 0.12. K23 I got it, you said that 0, minus 4, minus 4 because here. What is that F2? What is the F2 value is here? What is the force acting at node 2? What is the force acting at here, pa? 600, no? Hello?
600 into
3 newton, sir.
3 newton, sir.
Yes, that is why you have to substitute these two values now. Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
8 into 10 power 5. Into Q2 is equal to 600 into 10 power 3 minus of 4 into A3 0.12. That is what I written in the bracket. You can see here. I think it's visible now. Is it visible properly? 8 into 10 power 3 into Q2 is equal to 600 into 10 power 3 minus of minus 4 into 10 power 5 into 0.12. Then you can calculate the Q2. Check out how much Q2 will get. Same value. Hello? Q2, all of you check out. All of you got 0.81, you're getting? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Put a box for every answers, I told you. What is next step? Next step, what you have to do?
Determination test.
See, here there are two elements are there, not one element. Therefore, two element means two stress will get for every element. Therefore, if you want sigma 1, E into epsilon 1. If you want sigma 2, E into epsilon 2. Therefore, corresponding strain at element 1 and element 2, you have to find. How to find that? Here, very important. So, epsilon 1 is nothing but B1 into Q. B1 into Q. So what is B that you know? B1 in, B means strain displacement matrix, Q means nodal displacement matrix. So B means, you know, 1 by L minus 1, 1. This L is nothing but L1. L is nothing but L1. Element 1 belongs to how many nodes? Elements 2 belongs to how many nodes? Hello?
2, sir.
2, no? And corresponding, what is the nodal displacement? Corresponding, what is the nodal displacement here? This is the element 1. What is the corresponding nodal displacement here?
Q1 and Q2.
Therefore, here, epsilon is nothing but B into Q. V1 into Q, that is nothing but 1 by L1 minus 1, 1, and the corresponding nodal displacements are Q1 and Q2. I know already Q1. What is the value of Q1? Since it is fixed, what is the value of Q1? What is the value of Q1?
0.
And Q2 we already calculated just now, 0.81. And L1 is already, I know, in the figure they given, 150. Now you have to simplify. Understood? You have to calculate the strain and stress individually for the element, then you have to add it, you will get the total stress and strain. You got it?
Yes, sir.
All of you understand? Similarly,
sir.
What is epsilon 2 become? B2 into Q. What is B2? 1 by L2, correspond to element 2, 1 minus 1. And element 2 belongs to which node?
Element 2.
Element 2, please observe figure here. Element 2 belongs to which node?
2.
Then one more is?
3.
That is corresponding nodal displacement are Q2 and Q3. Therefore, that you have to substitute here. Where is that? Yeah. Q2, Q3. Q2 is how much? Q2 is how much? Just now we know.
0.81.
Q3? Q3 how much? Q3 how much, ba?
0.12.
Here we written, no, Q3 is nothing but gap, 0.12. Therefore, you all of you calculate epsilon and epsilon 2, simplified.
-4.6 × 10⁻³.
Which one? Epsilon 1 or epsilon 2?
Epsilon 2, sir.
Epsilon 2, sir.
-4.66 × 10⁻³. All of you got it? Epsilon 2. And epsilon, sir, you got it, sir. 5.4 × 10⁻³.
Yes, sir.
Now we got strain with respect to element 1 and element 2. Now similarly, now calculate all of you. Stress for element 1 is epsilon 1 into Young's modulus. And stress for the element 2, epsilon 2 into Young's modulus. You do it, all of you. Calculate sigma 1 and sigma 2. All of you calculate sigma 1 and sigma 2. 1080. Okay. Sigma 2. Huh?
-920.
Yes.
-920.
Therefore, sigma 1 belongs to which stress? Subject to which stress? Tensile or compression?
Sigma 1 tensile.
Sigma 1 tensile.
Yes. Why it is compression? Can you tell me, anyone tell me? Why sigma element 2 become compression?
Negative sign.
Negative sign, that is okay. How practical it is going to be happening in the compression stress here? By analyzing.
Both the ends are fixed.
Okay, both ends are fixed. What happened? If you apply the load force, what happened? Up to 0.12, it will freely expand. After that, what happened? There is a constraint. Because of that, there is a compressive force will be acting. But as the element 2 will be under tension only, it will be going to stretch. But this element 2, from this up to here, it is going to be compressed up to here under tension. Isn't it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Correct, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, last question is what?
Reaction, sir.
Reaction, sir.
Do it. All of you know how to find that. Do it.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Do it, all of your reaction. All of you there? You doing?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
We'll stop it. After this problem, we'll stop the class. Tell me quickly. We'll wind up today. After this problem. Next class, what I will do? I will explain you the steps. You take a screenshot, then you have to solve it yourself. After that, next class, you have to show that. Okay? Because once you're familiar, that you come easy. Next problem, sir, we'll solve it live. But after that, you will be. Which is very difficult, that we'll solve it here. Okay. Which reactions are zero now? Can you tell me? Where is the reaction will be developed? Where is the reaction will be developed?
R2.
Reaction will be developed at node 1, at node 2, or node 3?
Node
2, sir. Node 2, it will not develop. I told you how the reaction will be developed. Where actually reaction will be developed?
1 and 3.
1 and 3.
Why 1 and 3? Why 1 and 3?
Pixel.
Because? It is fixed. See, always keep this mate. Where it the fixed is there, no? At corresponding node only the stress will be developed. Sorry, reaction will be developed. Remaining it will not develop. Now tell me where and all R and 3. What about R2? R2 become what?
Zero.
R2 become zero. Now calculate all of your R1, R2, R3. I think in your calci, there is a matrix multiplication option is there, no? Correct, no?
Sir.
You enter this one.
Sir.
Get it. You can directly enter this matrix value and you multiply, you simplify like this, you can get it directly the value. What is R1 on of anyone got R1? You know Gavisidai sir, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, every time daily 1% bad.
Sorry, K into Q.
K into Q. ఫస్ట్ రో ఇంటూ ఫస్ట్ కాలమ్ ఫస్ట్ ఆర్ వన్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 4 × 0 ప్లస్ మైనస్ 4 × 0.81 ప్లస్ 0 × 0.12 మైనస్ 0 దట్ ఈస్ ద ఫస్ట్ ఈక్వేషన్ అర్థమైతా ఆర్ వన్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 10 పవర్ 5 ఇంటూ బ్రాకెట్ అల్లి బర్దిబిట్టు 4 × 0 0 లీవ్ ఇట్ ప్లస్ 0 మైనస్ 4 × 0.81 మైనస్ 4 × 0.81 ప్లస్ 0.1 × 0 0 మైనస్ 0 దట్ ఈస్ ద ఫస్ట్ ఈక్వేషన్ సెకండ్ ఈక్వేషన్ ఏం మాట్బేకు ఆర్ టూ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 4 × 0 8 × 0.81 మైనస్ 4 × 0.12 హోల్ × 10 పవర్ 5 మైనస్ 600 × 10³ దెన్ సాల్వ్ ఆర్ టూ అర్థమైతా ఆర్ ఇన్ యువర్ క్యాల్సి దెర్ ఇస్ ఏ multiplication is the matrix you can enter this matrix value and directly you can do it that also there okay, all of you got anyone r1 r2 r3 hello
sir r1 minus 3.24
minus
3.24
into
10 power 5
correct minus 3.24 into 10 power 5 yeah. Check out. Minus correct. 324 × 10³ R. And yeah, 3.24 × 10 correct. What about R3? Ruchita.
Yes, sir.
How much you got? R1. All of you understood how to you have to simplify. Anyone not understood? Tell me. Last time you done, no? Last two problems. Same thing you do it. Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Tell me. Yeah, I told you now how to do it. You do it like that and tell me quickly. Don't waste the time. Hello? All are there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Are you doing?
Yes, yes.
Tell me.
Sir,
minus 2.76 × 10⁵
Correct. 2.76 × 10⁵ or 276 × 10³. My R1 is minus 3.24 × 10⁵ or 324 × 10³. Correct. All of you got these answers, whereas R2 you get 0. Hello? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Can you add it this one? How much you got? Minus 320. This one, these two reaction R1 plus R2, R3, you add it. How much you got? R1, R2, R3, you add it. How much?
Minus 6 × 10⁵.
What is the total applied here? What is the total load applied? 600 × 10³, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Therefore, you got same, no? Magnitude, but opposite direction.
Yes, sir.
Therefore, your problem is right. Your problem is right. Suppose I say, can you calculate the stress and strain using a MOM approach? MOM approach al maadidirala. Idakke stress test barutha heltira? MOM approach alli. How to calculate the stress now?
PL by AE.
Hey, stress, sir.
Force per area, sir.
Per area, sir.
Do it. How much? Force is 600 × 10³. Area, do it. Divided by 300. Can anyone tell me 600 divided by 600 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 300, how much?
2 into 10 power 6.
6 3 na.
210 to 3.
That is 2000, no?
Yes, sir.
How much we got in our FEM approach? 1080 minus 1920. We add it. How much?
2000 only, sir.
That's all. Like that, you can verify. Got it?
Sir.
Reaction should be equal, means then your problem is right. Applied force equal to reaction. Otherwise, somewhere is wrong. You can verify. Or you can do approach the MAM method and you can calculate stress and strain. So if you that value got it, okay. Otherwise, it's somewhere wrong you done. Like that, you have to verify. Got it? But which is the very easiest now? MAM approach or FEM approach?
FEM approach.
MAM approach is, you know, one step you got the answer right. Load by area.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
But
yes, sir.
It become very lengthy. Then why people are using?
Load by area.
Why then you are using this one? See, for simple problem, FEM is not going to apply. But if you become complication problem, no, how are you going to approach for the complexity of the problem you can calculate using MAM approach? That become very difficult. Therefore, they have to apply this method. Now we are problems only and simple problems for you. But actually, it's a complex problem. You are going to apply this like aircraft structure. It may be like aerospace structure, aircraft structure, or it may be automobile structure. Then it is difficult, no? Then it is using this, you can get it easy. Understand? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hello,
yes,
sir. Please. Yes, sir. Understood the problems? Okay. That's all about the today. And today we are completed the first case problem. So two case problem. One is uniform bar with axial load, uniform bar with uniform load. Now next classes we are going to take for stepped bar. It stepped bar means area is different, and also suppose if they give you different material, so like that. How done in the MAM, no, in the same way. Okay. Is it clear, all of you?
Yes,
today
sir.
Class?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Almost it took 3 hours. Oh my goodness. Great. See that this is a problem. If you want to do live class, no, it take more time. So, but next classes I will explain like that. Simply just explain the steps. You can calculate yourself later after the class. Okay. If it time available like this, I will do it. Important problem I will do that in the live class. Don't worry. Got it?
Okay, sir.
Okay, attendance. Nagin Taj.
Yes, sir.
What, Nagin Taj? You are not answering anything, so you will come very quiet.
No, sir. Answering.
Okay, fine. Good. Nitish. Kishore.
Yes, sir.
Pavan.
Friend, sir.
Krupanand Reddy.
Friend, sir.
You also very quiet. Krupanand Reddy. Not answering. Prajwal.
Answering, sir.
Yes, sir.
Answering, okay. Punit.
Yes, sir.
Both Punit are there?
Yes, sir.
Wasim.
Present, sir.
No network problem, Wasim. Today, Ramchandra, Vijay Kumar. Hey, this Vijay Kumar, anyone having contact with the Vijay Kumar? Useless fellow, isn't it? Tell him to contact me immediately. This fellow. Ramchandra, Bharat Kumar.
Okay, sir.
Chitta.
Present, sir.
Shashavalli.
Present, sir.
Sheikh Basha. Chand Basha.
Present, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Mohammed.